And this is where I would be introducing Mr. Harvey. But Mr. Harvey had a computer crash. So he's not able to join us this morning. So I am going to do my yeoman's dead level best to give you the horror news. And here we go. All right. Horror film X centers on an adult film crew in 1979 rural Texas. This stars Mia Goth, Brittany Snow, Jenna Ortega, Martin Henderson, and Scott Muscuti, who's known as Kid Cudi. The film follows the crew as they get caught trying to make a porn in a haunted house, I guess. And they end up fighting for their lives. It debuted at South by Southwest, and director T. West has announced and revealed that the prequel has already been shot, and all he's got to do is put it together. According to the LA Times, he secretly filmed the prequel. It's called Pearl, and he shot it while filming the original. And the prequel is now in post-production. It follows Goth's second ex-character, Pearl, as a young woman during the World War I era. So, there we go. You got a sequel and a prequel all together at once. And didn't even know it, right? The reboot of Scream, which opened over Martin Luther King weekend, taking in $140 million so far at the global box office. Paramount and Spyglass have greenlit a sequel with the whole creative team returning. Directors Matt Bentinelli-Ulpin and Tyler Gillette, James Vanderbilt and Guy Busick co-writing the screenplay, Project X Entertainment's Vanderbilt, Paul Nienstein, and William Shirek producing. Paramount's dated this for March 31st, 2023. So there is that. And Paramount's also unveiled the first five shows for a new UK unscripted slate, and that does include a documentary on paranormal hauntings in the UK and the US. This is a show, the working title is called Haunted. It's from The Thief. Excuse me. It's from The Thief, his wife, and the canoe producer Story Films in association with All Three Media International. They'll explore and unpack cases that have captured the public imagination for many years on hauntings, poltergeists, and exorcisms. Paramount Plus Chief Content Officer of the UK, Ben Frau, says the debut slate illustrates the breadth of shows that will populate the streamer over across the pond. And in the wake of playing the Riddler, Paul Dano has gone and done something unexpected. And Matt Reeves has given us a look. Let me see if I can find where I put that. I didn't put it up there. He's written a book. He's written a comic book. He's written a Riddler comic book. And it's called Riddler Year One. And it's going to be out from DC this Halloween. So be checking out that. We'll see. It sounds like it's going to be a one-shot as opposed to an ongoing series. All right, we've got a Western horror film called Oregon Trail for Paramount. Michael Patrick John, you see him there on the right. He's been tapped to direct. Olivia Applegate, Clay Bennett, Zoe DeGrammaison, Nicholas Logan, and Sam Trammell, Jessica Francis Dukes, all in the cast. It's written by Meg Turner, finds a young Abigail Archer friendless and alone in a brutal Montana winter during the 1870s, fighting for survival and fighting to retrieve her one earthly possession, the family's horse, from a gang of bloodthirsty bandits. So there is that on the way. It seems like we're getting a little bit of a resurgence in Westerns of late, aren't we? Excuse me. C.J. Cook's supernatural family novel, The Lighthouse Witches, set to be adapted for television by Studio Canal and the Picture Company. They beat out a number of different bids for the rights to the books. This was published last year by Penguin Random House. The story follows a young mother named Liv, her three daughters. They arrive on a mysterious Scottish island to run a decrepit lighthouse, and the kids disappear. And then 22 years later, one of the kids reappears, same age as she was when she disappeared. So then, of course, the mystery ensues and probably gets a little complex from there. Blumhouse and Prime Video over at Amazon have won the world rights to Sundance horror drama Nanny. This is a competitive bid. Also included a number of different people going after this. Prime Video ultimately won, thanks to a deal in the $7 million range, according to reports. Jason Blum saw the movie and instantly fell for it. Wanted to include it as part of the company's Amazon deal, and it appears that there's also going to be a theatrical commitment. This is from first-time feature writer-director Nikyatu Jusu. It premiered at Sundance this year in the U.S. Dramatic Competition. It stars Anna Diop. You will know her from Titans. She plays Princess Coriander over there. She plays a Senegalese immigrant nanny, piecing together a new life in New York City while caring for the child of an Upper East Side family, who's forced to confront a concealed truth that threatens to shatter her American dream. So there is that. It looks like we're going to get that in theaters, in addition to over on Amazon. And Amazon and Hulu have swooped in for the sci-fi comedy drama Reginald the Vampire, starring No Way Home's Jacob Batalon. Excuse me. This show is going to be in select territories. Cineflix rights has come on board for the international distribution. It's a 10-episode series. They're going to be shopping it at MIPTV next month in Cannes. Hulu has acquired the Second Window United States rights. It's based on Johnny Truant's Fat Vampire novels. It's a comedy drama, stars Batalon as Reginald, a newly turned vampire who crashes into a world populated by beautiful, fit, and vain vampires. He's new and he has to overcome various barriers, such as a bully of a boss, falling for a human girl he can't have, and the vampire chieftain who wants him dead. And of course, he discovers that he has a few powers of his own. And given that it's a comedy, I'm sure that hijinks and hilarity will ensue. Interview with the Vampire series it's setting up over at AMC has cast Eric Bogosian in the role of Daniel Malloy. This is the part that was played by Christian Slater in the original movie. The series is currently in production. This is based on the Anne Rice book of the same name. And Bogosian is joining the previously announced cast members, Sam Reed, Jacob Anderson, Bailey Bass. Malloy is described as an investigative journalist nearing the end of his career. And Bogosian's age very much plays into that. He's given a second chance at the interview of a lifetime. Like I said, Christian Slater played the part in the film version. Bogosian is known for writing and starring in the play Talk Radio, which later became a film that he was in, directed by Oliver Stone. He's earned a Tony and a Pulitzer Prize nomination for that play. He's written several others and received 3 Obie Awards and the Drama Desk Award for his work on stage. Some of you may know him just as a film actor, but he's done a whole lot more. Alexandra Daddario has been cast in the lead role of the Mayfair Witches. This is a related series, also over at AMC, based on Anne Rice's The Lives of the Mayfair Witches novels. This was picked up to series at AMC back in December. Daddario will star as Rowan, a brilliant doctor who grapples with her fate as the heir to a family of powerful witches. Mayfair Witches was given an 8-episode first-season order. AMC plans to launch the show in its on its linear channel and the streamer AMC Plus later on this year. And a little bit of casting news here. Popular South Asian-Canadian actor Ahad Razamir has been cast in the Netflix original series Resident Evil. This is based on the video game. Variety has confirmed this. Netflix has not yet revealed the details of the character that he'll be playing. This is the live-action scripted series telling a new story that builds on the video game franchise. Lance Reddick is set to star as Albert Wesker. Here's the log line. Year is 2036, 14 years after a deadly virus caused a global apocalypse. Jade Wesker fights for survival in a world overrun by the bloodthirsty, infected, and insane creatures. In this absolute carnage, Jade is haunted by her past in New Raccoon City, by her father's chilling connections to the Umbrella Corporation, but mostly by what happened to her sister, Billy. So, family drama in the middle of a zombie apocalypse. So, there we go. Resident Evil will stream starting on July 14th. And then we have this. The director of The Nightmare Before Christmas is harnessing the power of Jordan Peele for a brand new stop-motion adventure. Henry Selick will direct Wendell and Wild, described as a dark and whimsical Netflix film based on the script by Jordan Peele and Henry Selick. It's been in development since 2015, and it's finally coming out. So the description here, it's an animated tale about scheming demon brothers Wendell, played by Keegan-Michael Key, and Wild, played by Peele. They enlist the aid of 13-year-old Cat Elliot, a tough teen with a load of guilt, to summon them to the land of the living. But what Cat demands in return leads to a brilliantly bizarre and comedic adventure like no other, an animated fantasy that defies the laws of life and death, all told through the handmade artistry of stop motion. So there is that. And this last bit here, it is the 75th anniversary of Vespa. And it's also the 40th anniversary of Elvira. So the Vespa dealership in Los Angeles, Vespa Los Angeles, putting together a special limited edition run of Elvira Macabre Vespas. It comes with special graphics on the leg shields, the bodywork, custom embroidered Elvira 40th anniversary seat with a leopard print panel, all kinds of chrome accessories, spider web on the shields, a special license frame, and much more, they say. Each of these 40 limited edition Vespas will be signed by Elvira, Cassandra Peters. And as a bonus, you'll get a special autographed copy of her autobiography, Yours Cruelly, Elvira, with each purchase. And this is only going to set you back $11,666. Dollars, but you know, that's just a little bit, right? And it wouldn't be it wouldn't be a horror report without an update from Rob Zombie. Let me see if I can get down here and get to that. Where did it? There it is. Rob Zombie posting over on Instagram, like he does, a series of photographs of the random set construction happening. And these were posted 4 days ago. He says these sets are going to be absolutely insane. This is, of course, for his production of The Munsters. And looking at all of this in color, somehow it just doesn't quite. I'm really hoping he does this movie in black and white, you know, because there's just something about that tone.
Good Morning Multiverse, every Saturday morning at 11 a.m. Eastern, 10 Central, right here on Sci-Fi for Me TV.